think about the inside of a membrane, it's a wall of polymer, and sugar and water are passing over that polymer that has holes that water can pass through, but that sugar cannot. And if you pass liquid over that membrane fairly fast, it keeps moving the sugar on. And if you slow it way down so that you get real high sugar coming out of this, then it actually plugs up with the sugar fairly quickly. The sugar adheres to all the holes and you can't get water through the membrane. So by pushing a whole lot of liquid through all the time, we can keep it operating at a pretty good clip. So a commercial membrane, a commercial RO unit like we have in the back room here, has a second pump that just really pushes liquid through there fast to keep that happening. This does not have what we call a recirculation pump on it. So we get the same sort of effect by just running the sap through fast and then running it through multiple times. Keeps the membrane functioning better. This is another tool that's very, very handy to have when you have an RO, because it'll tell the sugar content of the different things. So I can test the sap, which is only about 1.5% sweetness. I can test what's coming out of the RO, and that brings it up to just a little bit below 2. So we're gonna have to go through this, through the RO a number of times to get it captured. Now what I haven't looked at yet is my pressure. My pressure is actually kind of low. Get it up close to 200. So now you see it's not coming out of here with quite as much force. So it's restraining how much the concentrate comes out. That forces a little bit more water out of it. You can see that's how fast. This unit will take out somewhere between 15 and 18 gallons per hour. You can see it's going down, gradually being, the water's gradually being pulled out by the reverse osmosis. As you can see, it still is running a nice clip into our jug. That's pure water, as pure water as you can find. And we, of course, want to save all that so that we use it to wash our unit when we're done. So once again, on here I have the foot valve so that this line will always stay full of liquid. This one doesn't have quite as good a foot valve as the other one we showed. And then I have my shutoff valve right after the pump. And we'll see real quick here why we need that, because we're getting pretty low. We don't want to suck air into the system, then we would have to reprime our pump. Because of the way I have my pump mounted, in order to prime this pump, I have to tip the unit over to get the prime thing on top, and that's a real pain. Let's see how sweet we're getting here. Yep, we're now about 2.3. That shuts off the high pressure pump. Then I'm going to close this valve. So now the liquid from my foot valve all the way around through my pump is permanently locked in. The valve on one end, the valve on the other end. I don't have to worry about repriming it. I can pull this out, which I need to do so I can wash. I need to pull that out and drop it into my purified water for a cleaning cycle. And just a little bit of air got in there, not enough to mess things up. Now I can open this back up and we'll start a cleaning cycle. So what I need to use this for is I keep checking this to see when it is no longer sweet anymore. So it's still well over 2%. It'll take about a gallon before we start to see the sugar content drop. And I'm quite a bit less than 1%, so we shut off our pump,